Hi, I am Coach Christian, and today we are going to talk about grip. Not how to make a grip. This you can look at the coach lecture I posted last year, but give you some information so you can decide what and which grip is ideal for you. Actually, when we talk about grip, we are talking about something which is very individual, that one of the most important parts of the bow, because it's exactly that part of the bow that will touch your hand, or that part of your hand that will touch the bow. It should be as much comfortable for your hand. There will be as many grips as there will be archers' hands. When we talk about grip, we talk about three different grips. When people talk about grip, we say high grip, we say low grip, and there is something in between both that people say middle grip. What is high grip? What is low grip? Actually depends on you. If you get a grip from someone and you hold the bow and you say, oh, it's too low for me, it's low grip for you. But besides that feeling, there are some standards that people follow to recognize a high grip or a low grip. A high grip is actually something that you're holding the bow practically with your hand straight. You get your bow and you're holding it like this here. A great archer that uses a high grip is Valeva. I got here a picture on my laptop. I hope you can see it. When you have low grip, that's the kind of grip you will be holding a long bow. So if you have this here, you will hold a bow, your grip is very low, and then you have what people say middle grip. It's always in between those two positions. Each one of those positions have an advantage. For us to understand how to decide how should be the grip for us, let's analyze the high and the low grip. We talk about high grip. We talk about something that you put your hand practically straight out and you pull the bow. Anatomically, it's an excellent, extraordinary position for your hand and for your grip. Since all strength that comes through your forearm will pass in a straight line through your wrist. When you see people punching in martial arts, you will notice that they punch with the knuckle at the same height as the wrist. If they change this position, they may damage or even break the wrist, because the transfer of energy in this position is perfect. When you apply this to the bow, the same concept, on the bow, you will have a perfect transfer of energy. The only problem in a bow is that your hand is relaxed, and therefore your forearm will be relaxed. In martial arts, when you punch, your forearm is full of tension. It gives an extra strength because your wrist has no muscles. So while you're in a punch, you have a very firm unity by closing your hand very, very tight and strengthening your forearm muscles. In archery, you actually don't have it. Your forearm muscles should do nothing. Your hand should be totally relaxed. So the advantage of a low grip in being a perfect transfer of energy and force, in being and having a very little point of contact. Therefore, the probability of torque being a lot less than the other grips, and being that the point of contact on the bow, it's very near to the arrow, causing very little twist problems, as a draw set, a drawback, as a negative point. While you keep your hand relaxed, your wrist will be also relaxed. And it can happen after you shoot, your hand tends to move with the force of the bow coming forward and the string pushing the arrow, which will may cause the bow jump in different directions shot after shot, which give you an inconsistent shooting and arrow grouping. The second problem that you may find on a high grip is the pressure applied to the front of your hand here. It's totally on just one small spot, and exactly a spot where we actually don't have muscles, it's just skin. And this can cause pain. The third point you must think about it. When you have a high grip, the higher your grip is, the higher tends your shoulder to rise. Low grip, shoulder goes down, high grip, it go up. So, you have advantages, perfect force, small point of contact, hand nearby arrow rest. Negative points, loose wrist, pressure here, and your shoulder may rise. The opposite to the high grip is a low grip. The low grip, the big advantage, the low grip, it's a very firm position for your wrist. Your wrist just stays there. There is no way for your wrist to move during the shot sequence and after the shot. The disadvantages is that you have a very big area of contact, causing higher probability of torque problems. Also, the low part, it's too far away where you end up pushing, it's too far away from the rest. And after releasing, even so, this is very firm and very stable, sometimes you have a tendency to kick the bow. The bow will kick upwards, do too much pressure on the lower part of the body, since you're not pushing on the bow exactly in the middle. You will be pushing the bow a lot lower than the middle point, and especially where your fingers are pulling the arrow and the string. This is because that sometimes your arrow may be thrown up, or if the back part of the arrow still touches the rest by those up kicking, it will throw your arrow downwards. The second advantage on a low wrist is your shoulder goes down. So, low wrist has advantage. Very firm position of your hand and helps you to keep your shoulder low. Disadvantages, very far away from a rest, due to low contact point, may end up kicking your bow up, and you may have bigger problems with torque. Taking those extremes and trying to find something that is in the middle, people came up with a middle grip. This middle grip will depend a lot on how your hand is. Some big guy with a big hand will definitely have a different grip than a lady with a very filigree thin hand. Depends on what kind of bow you're using, what kind of grip it's coming with that bow, and many other factors. So, let us see a couple of bows and a couple of grips. Hoyt, GMX, and many other models come with a standard grip, which is for some archers very low. Coach Kim likes to put some material on top, so it's a little something like 1 to 1.5 centimeters higher in the back. So you get not a too low grip, a little higher grip. That distance depends a lot from archer to archer. Since I received this grip from Coach Kim, I tried to add more. At the end, I always was cutting it down back to its original height as Coach Kim passed me on. I have an archer of mine who has some shoulder height problem, but he still prefers a lot higher grip because he feels his hand is more consistent inside the bow, and then he must control more and take more attention to his shoulder. Some grips you can buy, like ergo grip. It's higher than the original grip that comes with the bow, and it's wider. Some people like it wider. It doesn't suit me, but this bow is of a student of mine, Luciano. He tried my grip. He tried many other grips. When he bought this grip, he put it on. It just fit his hand perfectly. So he said, no, I'm not going to change this grip. This grip is just perfect for me. Or you can do as Valeva does. Her coach, Marco Pedrazzo, makes her grip out of fiberglass. It's customized for her hand specifically. When you want to change your grip, when you look at the bow and you say, this grip is not okay, I want to fit it better so it suits target shooting, there are some elements which are standard. The first element which is standard, and if you look at this grip, it's slightly inward. How much this goes inward depends on you. The idea of having this grip going inwards is to help your hand to be in this position, which will help your front arm to get out of the line of the string, which in turn will help you to have a better arm-shoulder alignment. If the grip is done differently, if I would be using this grip as a left-handed, it will happen that my hand would have a tendency to turn outwards because the cut is outside. This is not very good because you're pulling and your hand is beginning to turn out, your bow is beginning to torque and turn around, and you will be very unsure during your shots. And your hand will be, while you're releasing, always in a different position. To have a grip going down and having some sort of edge so you can feel exactly where your hand stands helps you to keep and repeat the position of your hand over and over again on the grip. Second point you must take in account is this groove here. Some people who get the grip from factory comes with a bow and they put some additional stuff on it, they end up making it too high. If you make it too high, you will end up pinching your hand in the grip, and that can be very painful and very uneasy to shoot with. It should be in such a way that when you put your hand, the grip will cause that your hand moves inside, up and inside, in such a way that you can put the pressure up here. So you will be distributing the pressure in a bigger area than you would be doing on a high grip. At the same time, you will be avoiding putting pressure down here. You have here just as a reference point, but not as a pressure point. When you look at this grip and you check it, it's not as much inclined as it will be with the ergo grip, because this fits better my hand. I don't like it so much inclined as the ergo grip. How high I will make this depends on my feeling. You must check if it will affect your shoulders. If it does, then you must see if it will be not better to have a change in your grip. If you say no, my hand feels extremely well, like a glove, then you must work your shoulder. Conscience, keep your shoulder down, train stretching, elasticity of your muscular structure around your shoulder. But if you can change it, sometimes it will help. If you have a poor shooting, making error and mistakes, not necessarily will it mean is a grip. Sometimes it's technique. I have an archer of mine, he shoots pretty good, and he sometimes had a trouble, his hand just rotating outside. He was left-handed. But we analyze his shot sequence, and we begin to change the grip in many ways, many forms, making more steep, higher, lower, taking off, putting again. But actually his problem is not the grip. If you have a standard grip, slightly inwards, this nicely flat, points which are very nice to feel where your hand is, it's okay. Then we must check on something else. And we begin to check his front arm. And we discover that while he was pushing, he was relaxing his elbow a little too much. The movement was very little, but enough to cause a different energy direction. And so his hand would begin to slip sideways. So it was not a problem of grip, it was a problem of his technique and the way he was holding his front arm. Something that must be checked also. It can happen also that you start, you buy a bow, you start shooting, you feel good with one determined grip, and then you go and change your technique. Change the way your posture, hips, foot, change the way your expansion does, change the way you pull the string, change the way your shoulder and arm position are, and this will definitely change the way you will transfer energy forward to the bow, which at the end will also affect your position, your hand position, your hand feeling inside the grip. And this can cause you to need to change the grip. So it will fit your change on your posture. Sometimes it's posture, sometimes it's technique, but sometimes it's a grip. And sometimes a grip will affect your technique, will even cause you some pain, some lesion on your shoulder and arms, because if you're holding like this and pulling, you definitely will get, after a while, huge problem with your thumb. So you must check both. I started archery doing instinctive shooting. I started shooting archery instinctive, just with a stick and some wooden arrows. I did this for a couple years. Then I bought my first one-piece recurve bow. And after a while, I changed to compound a target. From that on, I went to the recurve target, where I spent many years in coaching and so on. And now, after many, many years shooting target, I'm coming back to my origins, which is recurve instinctive. For that occasion, I just a couple years ago bought myself this semi deer master takedown bow. It's not very expensive, nice to play around with it. At the beginning I just left it the way it was, since I only was shooting once a week or once every 2 weeks a couple of arrows. But I always had a problem with the grip of this bow. I'm telling this just for you to understand that sometimes you do must change something so it will fit your hand better. When I bought this bow, I felt it was just too fat here. I didn't want it to take anything from the side down because I don't know about the stability of the bow and the wood. Despite I like to shoot my self-made longbow, which is in the middle part thicker, but still feels very comfortable in my hand. This bow never felt really comfortable in my hand. By end of last year, 2011, when I decided to take it a little more serious and begin to train every day with this takedown bow, I began to think about how can I fit this bow the best way in my hand, instead of going on and trying to buy a new bow. This bow has some characteristics which I don't like very much on a grip. It has a very determined edge and high edge on the inside of the handle, and the outside here it just falls totally down. For right-handed shooter, it just means that by pulling, it's around, I pull around 48 pounds on this bow, by pulling my hand would just begin to slip outwards. Besides that, it has like had like a bump here, which would give me a very unpleasant pressure on my hand. In such a way, not only I would have a tendency to move my hand outwards, but also would have a tendency to want to change my hand after a while, because due to the pressure, it would begin to hurt my hand a little. First thing I did was take that bump away, take that edge away, and try to make it all straight and a little down. And then I went on to the shooting range and gave some 300 to 500 shots with this new grip, just to get feeling for the first change I did. After those shots, I realized it's still not okay with for me. So I began to make some pictures of how I'm shooting and checking where do I feel my hand feels very nice, tucked in and comfortable. And I just measure the distance. I put some rubber stuff in here, just provisory, to see how high I would feel comfortable to have my hand. And so I just cut a piece of wood, glued on, and put, and then I tested, and after I tested, I put some say leather on top of it, just to give a nice finishing and a very nice feeling of my hand on the bow. Now I have a bow that actually feels a lot more comfortable. I have an edge where I really can feel where my hand is. It's sort of a little falling down in such a way that my hand now feels very consistent and comfortable in the bow. Maybe it's not a traditional handle for a traditional bow. You go and buy traditional bows, handles look a little more different than that. I don't care. It's me who is supposed to shoot that bow. So I will fit the bow for me. Someone says, oh, that's not traditional. I wouldn't be shooting that bow. Okay, it's not his bow, it's my bow. Therefore, I just wanted to show you, sometimes what you get will need to be changed a little or even a lot, so it will fit you. There's not something that you can look in the internet where there will be the receipt, the perfect receipt, which if you do exactly that way, your grip will be perfect. What you need to do is to check some basic elements how your grip for a target bow should be. It should be inwards, it should be not pinching too much your hand in here. The height will depend how comfortable you feel, how good does it will guarantee you to push your hand inside the bow, and in relation to your shoulder. If it does not affect too much lifting or lowering, lifting your shoulder. Lowering is not a problem, but affecting lifting your shoulder. If you look those elements and you try out how you feel the best, you definitely will get success in building and adapting the grip for your own needs. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.